In the northern suburbs, Naval Station Great Lakes went into lockdown today because buildings had to be evacuated. Military dogs swept the area, all because a vehicle made an unauthorized entry.
The driver of that car is an employee on the base with authorized access. WGN's Julian Cruz is live near North Chicago with more on exactly what happened, Julian.
Lourdes, naval security investigators are still working at this hour to determine how this could have happened, or whether or not the driver in question could face citations or perhaps even criminal charges after forcing more than 25,000 people on this base, forcing them into lockdown.
At approximately 7 a.m. today, a male civilian driving a black Toyota Camry entered the base via gate 1.
Captain Ray Leung, commanding officer of Naval Station Great Lakes, describing what happened in North Chicago.
The driver did not follow the direction of the gate sentry.
The unexpected breach forcing a massive emergency response with a manhunt for the suspicious motorist.
My security force locked down the main side of the base and initiated force protection measures.
Allah, Allah.
Force protection measures, an unfortunate reality for U.S. installations around the world. The early January siege of the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad and the December terrorist attack at an Air Force base in Pensacola, Florida, killing 3 people, forcing U.S. commanders around the world to heighten security. But in today's incident, fortunately, Navy commanders say it wasn't terrorism. Naval security, aided by NCIS investigators and the FBI, all working together to find the missing Toyota Camry and the startled driver.
Navy law enforcement officials are conducting an investigation of the incident. We can confirm the individual is an employee on base with authorized access.
And that lockdown lasting just over 2 hours. Now, coming up in the 5 o'clock hour, it wasn't just the 25,000 people on the base who were inconvenienced. Thousands of family members were here for graduation ceremony. Coming up in the 5 o'clock hour, we'll tell you how that ceremony really was disrupted and delayed due to everything that was happening. In North Chicago, Julian Cruz, WGN News.